Science Explorers, it's Justin again, and this is a saguaro cactus. I've never seen a plant like this before. It's about 12 feet tall. Isn't it amazing that a plant can grow like this in a biome with so little resources? Today, we'll explore cacti and other desert plants and reveal the secrets behind their ability to thrive in the dry desert biome. We've learned about adaptations, physical and behavioral characteristics that help animals better survive in their habitats. Well, plants have adaptations too. These can help them to keep photosynthesizing in the dry desert. Do you remember what plants need to photosynthesize or make their own food? Take a moment to write down those three ingredients in your field notes and we'll review when you're done. Plants need water, sunlight, and air to make their food. Which of these ingredients would plants have to adapt to survive without here? Yeah, definitely water. Deserts experience droughts or long periods of time without rain. That means the plants here must have unique features that help them save water during a drought. So, what adaptations can we see on this cactus? What about it looks different from a tree you would see in the forest? Instead of having green leaves, the whole stem of this cactus is green. It's also pretty much all stem, no leaves or twigs to speak of. We noticed last time that cacti use their stems to store water, which is what makes them so thick. But why are they green? Usually a plant's leaves are green. Could it have something to do with them not having any leaves? Oh, I remember. The green color in leaves comes from chlorophyll. That's the substance inside plants that absorbs sunlight. Do you think cacti might have chlorophyll in their stems instead of their leaves? Oh, Mia says that water can easily escape through a plant's leaves. That's why cacti don't have any. It keeps the chlorophyll in its stem to absorb sunlight from there instead. In place of leaves, it has these spines that protect the cacti from being eaten. Some cacti, like this prickly pear, even have fruit with spines on them. Do you think these spines do anything else? If leaves could cause plants to lose water, I wonder if the spines have a way to help the cactus save water. Do you see how under the sunlight, shadows form under the cactus's spines? They help keep the cactus cool and shaded from direct sunlight to keep water in the stem from drying up. Ooh, check this out. It's an aloe vera plant. These are in the same family as cacti, the succulent family, or plants that have thick, fleshy parts for storing water. What characteristics do you notice this plant shares with a cactus? Aloe does have leaves, these long pointy ones, but like cacti, they have spikes at the ends to protect them from being eaten. The leaves are also fleshy, like a cactus stem, and are filled with a gooey, watery gel. You might put aloe vera gel on your skin after getting a sunburn. One thing we can't see that these succulents have in common is their roots. Do you remember what roots do for a plant? Right, they absorb water from the ground. But we learned that the ground here in the desert doesn't soak up very much water. How do you think a plant's roots could adapt to better absorb water here? If rainwater dries up quickly, where would be the best place to soak up water before it dried up? Yes, closer to the surface. Succulents have short, shallow roots, so they can soak up water quickly while it's raining. Looks like succulents aren't the only plants that can grow in the desert. Let's check out some of these trees and find out what they do to save water here. Huh. Does it look like this tree is shedding its leaves? The leaves it does have are really tiny. And a lot of them are falling off, like how a deciduous tree drops its leaves in the fall to prepare for winter. But it's not going to snow here, so why would it shed its leaves now? And do you see how its trunk and branches are green? That's odd. Do you think it's doing something similar to the cactus? Ah, Mia says that this is a Palo Verde tree. That means green stick in Spanish. It's a drought deciduous tree. So instead of shedding its leaves to prepare for winter, the Palo Verde sheds its leaves to prepare for a drought. I remember that deciduous trees pause photosynthesis during the winter when there's less water and sunlight. Does that mean the Palo Verde tree stops photosynthesizing during a drought? Oh, that's where the green branches come in. The chlorophyll in the branches can continue to absorb sunlight. But where is it getting water from? We know it can save water by having small leaves and shedding them, but is that enough to keep photosynthesizing? Ah, Mia says that unlike succulents with their shallow roots, the trees in the desert have something called a taproot. A taproot grows very deep into the ground. When it rains, some water soaks down into the ground and collects in spaces far beneath us. This underground water is what the taproot reaches for. Trees like this spiky Joshua tree have both a taproot and shallow roots, so they can absorb water from both the rain and from deep underground. Have you noticed that all of these plants are kind of spread out? They don't grow very close to each other like trees, grass, and other plants in the forest. Why do you think that is? There just isn't a lot of water to go around here, and the sandy ground cover holds very few nutrients. Plants can only grow where there are enough resources for them, where another plant won't absorb their water and nutrients. The way that plants have adapted to live in the desert is really amazing. I wonder what adaptations the animals here have. The animals we saw last time were kind of small. I wonder if we'll have to... Oh! Keep our eyes to the ground. Thanks for coming along with us today. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey!